Welcome to today's edition of the Exploring Mining Podcast, featuring stock news from TSX, TSXV, CSE, ASX, NASDAQ, and New York Stock Exchange mining companies, plus interviews with CEOs and leading experts. Hello, everyone. This is Sam Mowers here. Welcome to another episode of the Exploring Mining Podcast. For news today, we've got the latest from Nova Gold Resources, Hudbay Minerals, Seabridge Gold, and Avino Silver and Gold Mines. But just before we get into the show, a quick reminder that if you enjoy this podcast, please feel free to share it or leave us a review. And as always, I recommend checking out some of the other podcasts on investorideas.com as well. These include the Cannabis Podcast, the Clean Tech and Climate Change Podcast, along with many others, all of which will bring you up to speed on the latest stock news and trends in their respective spaces. All right, so Nova Gold Resources Inc., which trades on the NYSE American under the ticker symbol NG, has reported its 2023 first quarter financial results, as well as an update on its Tier 1 gold development project, Donlin Gold, which it owns equally with Barrick Gold Corporation. Barrick, by the way, trades on the NYSE under the ticker symbol GOLD. Now, the company boasts a strong treasury of $116 million in cash and term deposits as of February 28th this year, with an additional $25 million due in July this year. Regarding Donlin Gold, the company's CEO Gregory A. Lang said, quote, "As we have stated on numerous occasions, our board and management believe that the Donlin Gold project is truly best in class in its combination of attributes, and hence that Nova Gold constitutes the most perfectly suited go-to equity to benefit from the next wave in the bull market in gold." End quote. Stock for Nova Gold Resources is down 9.85% at the time of recording. Next up, Hudbay Minerals, Inc., which trades on the NYSE under the ticker HBM, has received approval for state permitting of its Copper World project. Phase 1 of Copper World, according to the press release, entails a 16-year standalone operation with processing infrastructure on Hudbay's private lands and mining occurring on patented mining claims. Upon receipt of the aforementioned permits, the company expects to conduct a bulk sampling program at Copper World to continue to de-risk the project by testing grade continuity, variable cutoff effectiveness, and metallurgical strategies. End quote. Stock for Hudbay is up 3.51% at the time of recording. Moving along, Seabridge Gold Inc., which trades on the NYSE under the ticker symbol SA, has announced that planning is well advanced for an extensive 2023 drill program at its 100% owned Iskut property. The Iskut property is located in northwestern British Columbia, Canada, in a region called the Golden Triangle. This will involve the program testing for deeper copper and gold porphyry systems and expanding the Bronson Slope mineral resource. Company chairman and CEO Rudy Franck said, quote, "Last year we discovered a major quartz magnetite breccia pipe beneath the Bronson Slope copper and gold deposit. The pipe sits within a district-scale structural trend that localizes all of Iskut's porphyry-style targets. The well-mineralized Bronson pipe is persuasive evidence of a large copper-gold porphyry source below last year's drilling. The structural trend hosting this pipe has two more similar porphyry targets meriting aggressive drill testing. As a byproduct of this effort, we expect to expand the Bronson Slope mineral resource." End quote. Stock for Seabridge Gold is down 2.06% at the time of recording. Lastly for today, Avino Silver and Gold Mines Limited, which trades on the NYSE American under the ticker ASM, has announced metallurgical results from the test work program on its oxide tailings project. David Wolfen, the company's CEO, comments, quote, "We are very pleased with these metallurgical results, which demonstrate excellent metal recoveries that would be suitable for a precipitating into bullion, Metallurgy is an important component in understanding the potential economics of our oxide tailings project. This project has been in our portfolio for many years and factors prominently into our 5-year growth plan to become an intermediate silver producer in Mexico. End quote. Stock for Avino is down 5% at the time of recording. Well, that does it for today's Exploring Mining podcast. If you'd like to be a guest or sponsor for this podcast, please contact investorideas.com. Investorideas.com reminds all listeners to read our disclaimers and disclosures on the investorideas.com website. All investment involves risk, and this podcast is not meant to be an endorsement to buy or sell securities or products. To hear more InvestorIdeas.com podcasts, please visit InvestorIdeas.com/audio. And a reminder, you can also hear our podcasts on Apple Podcasts, Audible, Spotify, TuneIn, Stitcher, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, and most audio platforms available.